Marita Mayra.
My name is Adriana Mayra.
First, we'll talk about secondary data. Secondary data is our data were collected by person or agency for review purpose on other than solving the problem at hand. In these figures that show, the secondary data is the various sources of the secondary data itself. The order from top to bottom, the correspondent roughly to the order in which alternative source should be considered. And that's almost all information. Information system initially are basically routinely collecting internal data and expand through the inclusion data from published data and standardized source of marketing data. And this is for uses, benefit, and limitation of secondary data. For the uses of the secondary data is first, secondary data may actually provide enough information to resolve the problem being investigated. The second is secondary data can be valuable source of new ideas that can explore better through primary research. And third, examining available secondary data is often prerequisite to collecting primary data. And fourth, secondary data is of use in the collection of primary data. And fifth, secondary data on how to define the population, select the sample in primary information collection, and define parameter of primary research. And the last also serve a reference base against which to compare the validity or accuracy of primary data. This is for the benefits and limitation of secondary data. You can see the benefit and the limitation. First, for the benefit is low cost, less effort expend, less time taken, sometimes more accurate than primary data, and the last some information can be obtained only from secondary data. For the limitation, is collected for some other purpose, no control of data collection, and might not be very accurate, might not be reported in the required form. The fifth, maybe object might not meet data requirement, and a number of assumptions have to be met. So when using the secondary data, it's important to go to the original source, because it's so important to compare the secondary data itself. And by doing so, you can determine who collected the data, why, where it was collected the data, how it was collected the data. And it's really the secondary data is can easily answer this question, because to help you to understand the quality of data. And the next is internal source of secondary data. Internal record itself is accounting and control systems, provide the most basic data on marketing inputs and the resulting outcomes. And the internal records and need to type there is data on inputs and extensive data on outcomes. In data on inputs, is marketing effort expended, can range from budget and schedule of expenditure to salespeople call report. And from the extensive data outcome, it can to be obtained from the billing records on shipment maintained in accounting system. For the using internal data effectively, there are two questions. There is, what is the effect of marketing inputs? The marketing inputs, number of sales calls or type of distribution channels on outcomes such as profitability and unit sales with region or sales territories. And the question two is, our sales performance with the key segment of type of retail improving or deteriorating. And many diagnostic to study diagnostic to study this question, because it can be undertaken with various combination on internal and external to answer this question. And The next is about the customer feedback. Customer feedback is so important to determine to responding to the voice of the customer. It's important because it can be maintained and increasing the market. And the next is about the customer database. Customer database itself is to raw information on the customer that can be stored and enhanced to produce the useful information. And for the external sources of secondary data is any published data source. Published data are by far the most popular source of marketing information. Not only are data easily available, often they are sufficient to answer the research question. For example, marketing managers studying developments in the wine industry will use the trade association data to learn how the total consumption of wine is broken down by type of customers, geographic area, type of wine, brand name, and distribution client. These data are available annually and sometimes quarterly, so significant trends can be selected regularly. And for the next in published data source is here any in external source of data secondary is authorities, general guides and indices, and compilation and directories. This is for the computer retrievable database. There are in computer retrievable database there are any two categories. Based on the method of storage and retrieval of information and based on the type of information. In based on the method of storage and retrieval of information, any online database and CD-ROM database. It can include in the classification of database on content of information. And for the based on the type of information, is any source and reference. It can be included in classification database on storage and retrieval methods. And the accessing computer retrievable database, online databases are accessible both from their producer and increasing from online information service. Most online service charge a fee for access to each database, a chart of the amount of information retrieved, and possibly supplemental charge depending on the nature of the information or the contract arrangement.
So next I will present about the advantage of computer retrievable methods. The main advantage of computer retrievable method is the scope of the information available on database. Advantage is the speed of information access and retrieval. Commercial available search procedure provide considerably flexibility and efficiency in cross-reference searching. This is for the limitation of computer retrievable methods. The reliance on the accuracy of the abstract author, the dependence on the journal and article selection policy of the database procedure, and the idiosyncrasies of the search procedure of the different database, as well as the different database network vendors from the enormous amount of information available online. The limitation, this is limitation because the computer search is based on finding certain keywords. With the database, there is possibility that some important will be missed if an abstract is missing a keyword. This is for the census data. Census data is the demographic, economic, and social statistics contained in great detail in census data. Are key aspect of many marketing study. For example, in company Y must decide where to locate a new shopping mall and which kind of store to install. This decision will require first the census of population information about the population with access to proposed location, and the second census of retail trade information about likely competitors and local wage levels, and The last one is census of construction industry, information about land development, contractors and construction costs available by state and metropolitan area. This is the North American industry classification system. The North American industry classification system, or we can say is NAICS, is the new standard code system to describe business establishment and industry, replacing the standard industry classification or SIC codes. It is the first industry classification system developed in accordance with a single principle or aggregation. The principle that producing needs that use similar production processes should be grouped together in the classification. This is some example of North America industry classification system. There's a NAICS level, which is there is sectors, sector, industry group, industry, and US industry. And this is the NAICS code, and the description is about information, broadcasting, access internet, radio MTP, radio broadcasting, and radio station. Here's some questions that appraising the secondary source. First is who. Who is this question? Applies especially to reputation of collecting agency for harness and to true work and character of the sponsoring organization, which may influence the interpretation and reporting of the data. And the second question is why. Why is the data that are collected to further the interest of a particular group are especially suspect? Media buyers, for example, soon to be wary of study of media. It is easy to choose unconsciously this method of question analysis procedure, and so forth that favor the interest of the study sponsor. And the third question is how. The question is, it is impossible to appraise the quality of secondary data without knowledge of the methodology used to collect them. And then for one are irritating and prevalent problem is the classification that are used, wide variation in geographic, age, and income grouping across studies are common. And then the fifth one is when there is something less interesting than last week newspaper, sooner or later the pace of change is the word general, and in market particulars renders our secondary data equally absolute and uninteresting except to the historians. And then the about consistency. The consistency is with all the possible pitfalls in secondary data. The difficulty in identifying the fully the best defense is to find another source that can be used to basis for the comparison. This is the application of secondary data for demand estimation is a key determinant of the allocation of source. There is a census data. The second is NAICS, trade association data, and expert and authorities. And then monitoring the environment. Monitoring environment is very crucial these days because it is highly volatile because attitudes, fashion, and foods change so often. Like press release, legislation, law and laws, industry news, business and practice. Dictionary literature such as magazine. And then segmentation and targeting. Segmentation and targeting is common among business seeking to improve their marketing. Like PRISM, Cluster Plus, DMI, NICS, and Tiger. And then developing a business intelligence system. The system is basically a system that contains data on the environment and the company. Like competitors annual report, press release, blogs, and competitors web page. And then sources of secondary data for international marketing research. Secondary data are a key source of information for conducting international marketing research. This is in part due to the ready availability, the high cost of collecting primary data versus the relatively low cost of secondary data. And the usefulness of secondary data is assessing whether specific problems need to be investigated. And if so, how further secondary data sources are particularly valuable in assessing opportunities in the countries with which management has little familiarity and in product market at an early stage of market development. This is about the problem associated with secondary data in international research. The data accuracy. Data accuracy itself is the data varies from one country to another. Data from highly industry nations are likely to have higher levels of accuracy than data from developing countries. Because of the difference in the sophistication of procedure adopted, the level of literacy in country also plays a role in the accuracy of macroeconomic data collected in the country. And then comparability of data, it is the business statistic and income data varies from country to country because different countries have different structure and different levels of taxation. It may not be useful to compare this statistics across countries. Population censuses may not only be inaccurate, they also may vary in frequency and the year in which they are collected, although in the United States they are collected. The last is about the application of secondary data in international research. For this one is first to application to selecting countries or market that merit in depth investigation. This is the first procedure of classifies a country on two dimensions. First is the degree of demographic and economic mobility and then country domestic stability and cohesion. And then the second procedure is calculate multiple factor indicates from different countries. And then second application is making an initial estimate of demand potential of a given country or a set of countries. There is four type of data are unique to demand estimation in international context. The first one is lead-lag analysis, and the second procedure is the use surrogate indicators. The third is technique is which relies on the use of cross-sectional data, and the fourth one is the most complex forecast model is the econometric forecasting model. And the third is about monitoring environmental change, which is the required surveillance of a number key indicator. This should be carefully selected and tailored to the specific product or range of product with which management is concerned. There is two type of indicator. First one is the general health and growth of a country and its economic and society. And the second, that of specific industry or product market. Yeah, that's all from us. Maybe any question?
Okay, maybe any question for this group? secondary data, the use.